सी अनदर क्वेश्चन गोज लाइक दिस क्वेश्चन दैट इज विदाउट प्लॉटिंग सपोज द क्वेश्चन इज गिवन लाइक दिस देन हाउ विल यू फाइंड द आंसर फॉर इट सी विदाउट प्लॉटिंग गिवन पॉइंट्स ऑन अ ग्राफ पेपर इंडिकेट दैट मीन्स वी आर नॉट सपोज टू यूज द ग्राफ पेपर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चंस ओके इंडिकेट द क्वाड्रेंट्स इन विच दे लाई ओके नाउ फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन गोज लाइक दिस abscissa equals to -3 and ordinate equals to -5. This is first one. Second question goes like this. Ordinate equals to 2 and abscissa equals to -3. Third question is abscissa equals to -4 and ordinate equals to 3 and fourth question equals to ordinate equals to -3 and abscissa equals to 3 okay now suppose these questions are given then we know that abscissa means x axis and ordinate means y axis so answer for the first one okay abscissa x axis means we'll write in x axis place what is the value -3 now ordinate means y axis now what is the value for y axis -5 Now, when both x-axis and y-axis both are negative, in the quadrant 1 first I have explained you in this lesson only, when both are having negative, where this point lies, in which quadrant? Yes, it is the third quadrant, very good, where both the x-axis values and y-axis values both are negative, okay, so the point will lie. You can write here the point will lie in third quadrant okay now the second question what was that this is about the first one now second one what was it ordinate means as I said it is y axis now abscissa is what -3 so we'll write what here first -3 because x-axis will come first so abscissa is -3 and y-axis is what 2 okay you can see here y-axis is 2 so we'll write here 2 now this point will lie in which quadrant it is as it is minus means x is minus but y is positive means where it will lie in the second quadrant so you can write the point will lie in second quadrant okay now third one what is the third point abscissa means x axis so write here x axis first then ordinate 3 ordinate means y axis that is 3 same you can see in the like the above question only x is negative but y is positive so the point will lie where yes that is in the second quadrant the point will lie in second quadrant okay clear understood children same way a fourth question ordinate means y axis and abscissa means x-axis so x-axis will write first that is +3 and y-axis is -3 so you can see x is positive means towards the right side. But y is negative, means below line. So which quadrant it will be? Yes, very good. It will be your fourth quadrant. The point will lie in fourth quadrant. Fourth quadrant. Okay, understood, children? This way, any type of such questions you can solve. Okay. Yes. Now see, children. Exercise 3.3. Now let us deal with exercise 3.3. Okay. So the first question is: in which quadrant or on which axis do each point lies? These points are given: -2, -4, -3. -1, -1, 0, -1, -2, and -3, -5 lie. Means every coordinates, these coordinates in which quadrants they lie or on which axis they lie, you have to show. Verify these answers by locating them on the Cartesian plane. Okay, that means we have to plot the Cartesian plane for it. Now let us see. Now here, for example, let us draw the line. So you have to use your graph paper. Okay, use the graph paper, Cartesian plane, x-axis and y-axis you will draw. So okay, now this is suppose x bar, and then this is y dash and y. Equal distance, this intersection point is origin. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so same way to the negative side you will go -1, -2, -3, -4, -5. So distance between the numbers must be the same. Okay, same way to the above y-axis 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Same way go down -1, -2, -3, -4, -5. Okay, clear? This is called the Cartesian plane, where we have horizontal line, that is x-axis, and vertical line called y-axis. The intersection of both is your origin. Okay, now what is the question? First one is -2, -2 and 4. So -2 means x-axis is -2. Go for this. 1, 2 x-axis. Y is what? 4, means positive up will go. That is 1, 2, 3, 4. So here it will come. Okay, you have to locate in the graph. So likewise. Okay, so now this point lies where? In which quadrant? This is, we know that this is first quadrant. This is first, this is second quadrant, this is third quadrant, and this is called fourth quadrant. Okay, now this point, first question, where is it lies? It lies in second quadrant. So we can write that the first question lies in, the point lies in second quadrant. Same way, what is the next question? You can see that the second question is 3, -1. Okay, so second one is, you can write the points here in the corner, that is second one, 3 and -1. So 3 means plus. Plus means x-axis plus values will take 1, 2, 3. And y is what? -1. Minus means will go below the origin. So that means here somewhere. Because this is -1. So here we'll get this point. So now this point lies where? In which axis? Which quadrant? It is in the fourth quadrant. So second question lies in first questions, second one lies in fourth quadrant. Okay, Now third one is what? Minus 1, 0. So minus 1 means x value is minus 1. So we'll move to the right side, left side, and y value is 0. That means here only the point will come. This is minus 1 and 0 point. That means the point lies where? In x-axis. The point lies in x-axis. No quadrants. It will lie in axis itself. Okay. So the point lies in the x-axis. Okay. Then the next question is, next question, that is 1.2. 1.2 means here 1 is what? X-axis is 1. Next value is 1 and 2. 1 and 2 where it lies, x value is 1. 1 means here. Y is positive 2. Positive 2 means we will move up. So here. So this will be here somewhere. So now this point lies where? You can see there. It is the first quadrant. So the next one lies in the first quadrant. Okay. Now the next question is minus 3, minus 5. So minus 3, minus 5, next one you can write minus 3, minus 5. That means you pointed out this one in that Cartesian plane. Minus 3 means x value is minus 3. So we will move towards the left, minus 3. And minus 5 means below the margin will go. So now you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 is marked. Okay. So minus 3 and 5, minus 5. So it will be like here. Now where this point lies, in which quadrant? Third quadrant. So likewise, if any question is asked, given points are given, and it is asked that where it, these particular points lie in the Cartesian plane, so for that you have to plot the Cartesian plane graph likewise and show the points and tell in which quadrants they lie or in which axis they lie. Here in this question, all the points are lying in one or the other quadrant except this one. This is lying on the x axis. Clear, children? Now see the second question. Second question goes like this. Plot the points x and y. So now here x and y coordinates, points are given in this table. You can see x means x place every time the value will change. First time it will be minus 2, second time it will be minus 1, third time it will be 0, fourth time it will be 1, and fifth time it will be 3. Same way y coordinate value also will change. Okay, because the points we know that it will be in the form of x comma y. That means x values, x axis value and y axis value. Okay, so now every time the x coordinates and y coordinates will change to have the graph, points on the graph. Okay, so now see the value, when the value of x is minus 2, y value will be 8. So seeing this, we'll plot first in the graph paper. Okay, the way we have done for the other questions, same way, take a graph paper, draw x-axis and y-axis, the intersection of both x-axis and y-axis, mark it as origin O, and then give the numbers to the right side of the origin. On x-axis, give 1, 2, 3 positive values, and to the left side, give minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, and so on. Okay, same way, from the origin above, move to the up vertical line. So it will be plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4. Same way from the origin lower portion or lower down or below the margin, below the origin, it will be minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, and so on. Okay, now specify these points in that graph paper. Okay, when x is minus 2, means to the left side you will go to the origin for minus values, and a y value will be 8. So point out that point in the graph paper. Okay, same way the second one point, that is minus 1, means again x values to the origin's left side, and y is positive means above the origin, above the origin vertical line. Okay, seventh point. Then comes 0. 0 means x coordinate will be 0. X coordinate will be 0 means it will be lying on only y-axis. Okay, So y axis point will be 1.25. Okay, and then comes third one, that fourth one, that is 1 and 1, 1 and 3. Okay, so 1 and 3 means what? X value is 1 and y value is 3. Same way x is positive, means to the right side you'll go of the origin. Same way 3, y is also 3 positive, so above the origin line, in vertical line. Okay, y axis 3. And again same way the last point, that is 3 and minus 1, means x is 3 positive value, means to the origin's right side you'll go 3 digits, 3 numbers, 3 units. And here to the y axis below the origin, means down area will go below the origin, minus 1. Okay, likewise solve this question in your graph paper. If you are not able to do it again in the class, when the school reopens, you may ask your doubts. Okay, thank you.